I gotta tell you, I love cars. I love the hunt for the car. I love the first drive behind the wheel, the cleaning, the maintaining, the servicing, the getting it running right, the enjoying it on the highway. I enjoy spending time in these cars with my family. What I don't love about these cars though, is the long-term ownership, the cost of keeping and maintaining, the marriage that goes with it. And that is why I made a commitment to myself to get a dealer's license. And I achieved that. I got a wholesale dealer's license through the state of Delaware. And that dealership is right here, right in my garage. And getting that dealership license was easier and less expensive than I ever imagined it would be. However, it took way longer than I ever imagined as well. And in this video, I'm gonna share with you those pros and cons and what it took and the effort and the requirements and the rules and regulations about getting a wholesale dealer's license. Now, a good place to start with this is the why. Why get a dealer's license? And for me, it really came down to three key factors. One, I got frustrated with paying 4 1/3% to the state of Delaware on the purchase price of every car. I got tired of the state of Delaware saying I can only sell 5 cars a year, and that's a rule for private sales. And thirdly, I wanted access to the cars that I normally wasn't able to get a hold of. The cars that the dealers only could get, the auctions that only dealers could get into. I wanted access to that. I wanted to get in there. I wanted to see the cars, to see the wholesale selling prices, and I wanted to be a part of that. Now, when you're talking car dealer license, there's two types available. There's a retail dealer license, which requires a retail car lot and the expense of owning and leasing that property, the office hours, the overhead, the insurance, and so forth. And then there's the easier route, the route I took, which is the wholesale car dealer license. Now, in order to get that license, a wholesale license, there are 7 requirements that the DMV requires. Now, those 7 requirements isn't anything monumental. It's actually quite simple, really. The first one is I need to have a Delaware driver's license for at least the past 90 days. And that was easy, no big deal. The second is I needed to incorporate. I needed a corporation name. And in Delaware, it cost $300, took about an hour. And now my official car dealer name is East Coast Classics, LLC. Pretty cool. Thirdly, I needed a home office. And my garage is my home office now. Part of the requirement of a home office, I needed a filing cabinet, check, a copier and printer, check, a phone, check, and a desk. That is it. That's all is needed for a home office. And then requirement number 4 was a review of my zoning to make sure I'm permitted to have a home office on my property. And that review cost $85. Number 5 is background check. I had to go down to the state, get fingerprinted, make sure I'm not a felon, there's no criminal history, no outstanding warrants, all that checked out fine. Number 6, I needed 2 business licenses. First is a car dealer license for $85 for the year. The second is a wholesale car dealer license for $100. And then again, that covered me for the year. And lastly, the 7th requirement of a wholesale car dealer, I need to sell a minimum 5 cars a year. Now, all in, I paid about $700 to get that wholesale car dealer license. 2 of those fees are reoccurring. The annual incorporation fee, the $300, and the 2 dealer licenses are reoccurring. So $500 is gonna reoccur every January. I have to satisfy those 5 car minimum sales in a year. But otherwise, I'm operating. I got my dealer license numbers and I've got my licenses and I get into these auctions that I've always wanted to get into. Now, this whole process took 7-8 months or so to get done. I could not believe how long it took to get fingerprinted, and apparently child care workers are prioritized and they get first dibs. If I had to do this all over again, I think I would do the zoning first and then get the fingerprinting scheduled, get that done. That takes about 2 to 3 months or so, and then pull it all together with all the paperwork and the documentation and send it into the DMV. I could probably cut the wait time to get that license down by half if I just knew in advance how long some of these processes were gonna take. Now, this dealer license has a lot of perks, right? But it also has one big knock on it, and that is I cannot sell cars to the public. I can't. If somebody wants to buy one of these cars, I cannot sell it to you. I have to sell it to a dealer or sell it through another auction first. That's the only way I can sell a car as a wholesale car dealer. Now, I'm still trying to navigate my way through some of this, and what I've determined is that I can also partner with a regular retail car dealer and I can sell my cars through that dealer. However, they want a cut. They want a piece of that. Now, as an example, if I want to sell this Lincoln here in the garage, I cannot sell directly to you, a retail buyer. I have to sell this car first to a retail car dealer, and that dealer would in turn sell it to you. And that doesn't prevent me, however, from handling all the arrangements, coming up with the sale amount, the finding the buyer, the negotiation price, the showing the car. I can still handle all that. However, the sale and the paperwork has to roundabout go to that retail dealer first. Now, one of the other knocks on a car dealer license, and it doesn't matter if it's wholesale or retail, is the dealer tag. That's the key to this, right? I'm trying to avoid those DMV fees, and I want to be able to drive the car. And even though I can print a temporary tag on my printer as a dealer for 20 bucks, I get a 60-day temporary tag, I want to drive the car more than that sometimes, more than those 60 days. And in order to do that, I need a dealer tag. And those dealer tags are expensive. It's the insurance on those dealer tags that matters. The tag is cheap. The physical tag costs nothing. It's the insurance. And insurance costs $250 a month, and that amount gives me $10,000 worth of coverage for the car, meaning that of all the cars under the dealership, if a tornado came through, smashed up all my dealership cars, I'm limited on the amount of money I'd recoup to $10,000. That's it. Now, that tag can go on any dealership car, and I can drive the car for pleasure up to a 100-mile radius in one direction, but the limited coverage hurts. And in order to increase that coverage, the prices just go exponentially up. And that is a big issue. Now, that dealer tag also allows me to avoid all those DMV fees at 4 1/3%. And that's a big deal. But there's a downside, and that's the insurance cost. And so now I'm trying to figure out the best way to leverage my dealership, my name, that dealer tag that I'm planning on getting very soon, and making a few bucks at this at the same time. Now, this is all about fun, right? The dealer tags, the dealer license, these cars, this is fun for me. This is a hobby, but I want to be able to leverage what I've done so far and take more advantage of what the next steps are. And frankly, I don't know what they are. I don't. And this is going to be an evolution. I just don't have the answers right now, but this is going to be a fun learning curve. And this is my first step towards figuring it all out. And we're going to take that journey together. So yeah, that's the process of getting a wholesale car dealer license. And I bet the process here in Delaware is substantially similar to the process in your state too. And the whole idea here is just to leverage it and take best advantage of what's in front of you and what's available to you. So that's my video. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you got something out of it. I hope it was entertaining, and I'll see you next time.